We're learning more tonight about the arrest and firing of a top administrator at Jacksonville's Episcopal School. News 4 Jax has obtained court documents that provide new insight on why he is now locked up. Episcopal fired the head of the upper school, Matthew Kearney, before he was arrested yesterday in Alachua County.
The arrest was on a stalking charge here in Duval County. We're now finding out more about an injunction filed by his ex-girlfriend, who, according to the Florida Times Union, is a teacher at Episcopal. Channel 4's Ethan Calloway joining us live from St. Nicholas after examining that paperwork. Ethan.
And this is a copy of that injunction, Joy. In it, it describes the details of what allegedly led to Kearney's arrest. Still, officials here at Episcopal claim that arrest and firing had nothing to do with the school itself. The claims made by Matthew Kearney's ex-girlfriend paint a picture of a man who stalked, harassed, and threatened her on a regular basis. Shortly after the injunction was filed, Kearney was fired from his job as a top administrator at Episcopal and later arrested on stalking charges.
But looking at the date violence, looking at what she was saying in the dating violence injunction, this person appeared to be very unstable, putting a gun to his own head, saying he was going to kill himself and that type of thing. That's why they issued the injunction.
The injunction shows that incident led to Kearney being Baker-acted and placed in a mental health facility. His ex-girlfriend claims he would stalk her repeatedly after she broke up with him and at one point threatened to hurt her friend. We spoke with News 4 Jax crime and safety analyst Gil Smith about how effective injunctions like this one really are.
We hear about the cases when someone violates the injunction and they become very violent by harming them or killing them. But hundreds of these injunctions are served every day. I served them for the last 3 years I was in the sheriff's office, and I served about 3 or 4 every day. And in most cases, the people do stay away.
In this injunction, Kearney's ex-girlfriend states, quote, "He is unstable. I think he will continue to stalk me. Every time I've attempted to break up with him, he begins to stalk and harass me until I give in. He follows me around work, texts me, and calls me constantly." She continues, saying, quote, "He states me and his job are all he had, and now that he no longer has his job, I believe his focus will be on me. I just want him to leave me alone."
She may have provided police reports or had some type of proof or evidence, or just told her story about the dating violence that was occurring between the two.
And as of tonight, Kearney is being held in the Alachua County Jail on $100,000 bond. We are live in St. Nicholas tonight. Ethan Calloway, Channel 4, the local station.
Ethan, has Episcopal said anything yet about why exactly they fired Kearney?
Well, Joy, as I mentioned earlier, they've really been underlining the fact that none of this had anything to do with the school or a particular student, but they do say they cannot comment on the specifics of his firing based on their overall protocol. Joy.
All right, Ethan Calloway reporting live for us tonight. Ethan, thanks.